Well, is your mind made up?
Sorry. It looks like I'm going to have to leave you now. One day, I hope you'll give this ring to someone you love as well as I love her.
Sweet child, you have finally come. I am so happy. It does my heart well to see you here, safe and sound.
Have you made your decision, Professor? Thankfully, Rhea has survived her trying ordeal. However, there is no telling how much longer her light will continue to shine.
Professor, have you decided? Will you become the next ruler of Fodlan?
Before I hear your answer, I shall fulfill the promise I made to you. You will know the truth about your identity. I will hold nothing back. I created you. And within you is the crest stone of the progenitor god. I hid the crest stone within your heart in order to revive her. Sweet child, I am sorry. I wanted to see her, see my mother, even if it meant doing that which is forbidden. I thought that I could regain all I had lost, if only I could revive my mother. And so I tried to bring her back by creating a body and then burying a crest stone within it. A young woman I created, my 12th try after much heartache, was a failure. She grew up lacking the conscience of the progenitor god and fell in love with the captain of the Knights of Zeros. In time, she became pregnant, but she and the child were not able to survive the birth. The child she bore was not breathing, and she herself was in grave danger. The new mother pleaded with me to take the crest stone of the progenitor god from her own body and place it within the baby. If I had done nothing, both mother and child would have died. And so I granted her final wish. As she had hoped, the baby started breathing again. The new life was saved. Your life, sweet child. Well before that, I had saved Gerald's life using the power of my blood. That means you are the child of a mother born of the progenitor god's crest stone, and a father who carried my own blood. I knew, deep in my heart, that you would be capable of housing the conscience of the progenitor god. I was right. And yet, she merely gifted her power to you, and then disappeared once more. My dearest wish did not come true, but here you are. You alone wield the power of the progenitor god. And now, I must ask you to use that power to save this world. You must... What? No!
Rhea!
What is wrong? Please calm yourself, Rhea!
Is the power of the crest taking over her body? Why is this happening?
Seth, it's terrible. White beasts have appeared all over Garrick Mach. It's hard to believe. but there have been reports that the priests and knights have been changing form.
White beasts? Are they the ones Rhea shared her blood and stones with?
Seth, demonic beasts are heading this way!
They are after Rhea. Professor, our situation is dire. If we do nothing, Fodlan will be destroyed by a rampaging Immaculate One and these children of hers! There is only one way to stop this. We must... Damn it! We have no choice but to kill the Immaculate One! To kill Rhea!
Though showing brief signs of recovery, even Rhea's strength has its limits. Having changed form to the Immaculate One, she is unable to control her power. As if in response, priests and knights who are directly related to Rhea by blood change into white beasts themselves. Facing this unexpected threat, the Resistance Army prepares for its final battle to save Fodlan.
Kept secret, but there is a certain rite that all initiates to high office in the church must undergo. In this rite, one pledges to serve the goddess, and in return receives a crest stone fragment and blood. The ones who have transformed alongside Rhea just now are the ones who have accepted those gifts. They will shield Rhea, the Immaculate One, I should say, with their very lives. But if we do not strike her down, Fodlan will have no future. To arms! Surrounded already, it seems. The white beasts are those in whom Rhea's blood flows strongest. Until we get rid of them, we will not be able to so much as touch Rhea.
Damn! After all that's happened, why do we have to kill Lady Rhea?
What's my strategy?
It's over!
It won't be in vain.
Put me in there.
I will prevail.
I'd be honored.
Shall we?
I'll cut through.
What's the plan?
I'll do my best.
I'm awake.
Ready for anything.
I do this for all of us. More fighting.
Allow me to die!
All is going to plan.
Keep it up.
as I...
What's the plan?
Ready for anything.
Shall we?
This is as far as I go. Why?
What's the plan?
Let's finish this!
Shall we?
I'm awake.
Ready for anything.
I do this for all of us.
I'd be honored.
They're coming one by one from the southern stronghold. If we do not capture it, there will be more.
Put me in there.
What's my strategy?
I will prevail.
More fighting.
I'll cut through.
I'll do my best.
Any damage to the Immaculate One will only be transferred to those beasts.
It is seeming that my understanding of Fodlan tradition is insufficient. What is happening?
It is too dangerous to approach her now. Capture the southern stronghold first to seal the beasts away.
Thank you.
use. Each battle a victory.
Must defeat the beasts before. Oh no. Rhea, what's happening? Rhea, not even I have seen this form.
I'm dying for some.
Put me in there.
I will prevail.
What's my strategy?
I'd be honored.
Shall we?
What's the plan?
I'll do my best.
I'll cut through.
More fighting.
Put me in there.
I will prevail.
What's my strategy?
I'd be honored.
I'm awake.
I'll do what it takes.
Shall we?
I do this for all of us.
Ready for anything. What's the plan?
I'll do my best.
I'll cut through.
More fighting.
Pull back yet.
Don't bother haunting me.
Must lead them well.
That was fun to watch.
Not finished yet.
Put me in there.
Just be careful.
late to run.
There's no turning back now.
Huh. Impressive. Just be careful.
I'll do my best.
Not finished yet.
I'll cut through.
More fighting.
Is it too late to run?
I do this for all of us. I'll be home again soon.
What's my strategy?
Put me in there.
I will prevail. Shall we?
Ready for anything.
Pull back yet. Attack at your own risk.
Leave.
Leave. won't stop me!
Knew you could do it. What's the plan?
Must lead them well.
That was amazing.
I was just stronger. For our future. That took
Wow. Amazing, shall we?
Won't be in vain.
I'll try.
More fighting.
Put me in there.
The plan.
I must lead them well.
Turn our attention to the Immaculate One.
This is it. The final battle.
Rhea! Not even I have seen this form.
Well, that's something, isn't it? A shame we must kill her. Consider the research potential.
I'm awake.
I'd be honored.
Going to plan.
Do this for all of us. Be careful.
Dying would defeat the purpose.
About this.
Be careful.
Can't pull back yet.
I'll cut through.
My strategy.
I do this for all of us.
I'm awake.
Dying would defeat the purpose.
I'll do my best.
Must pull through. What's my strategy? I must pull through.
This could turn the tides.
I may not survive.
I'm awake.
Do this for all of us. I shouldn't strain myself.
What's my strategy?
What's the plan?
Be careful. Be careful. Was there? Be careful.
What's my strategy?
Be careful. I'll do my best.
I'm awake. I'll cut through.
I will prevail.
What's the plan?
I'd be honored.
Put me in there.
What's my strategy?
Be careful. I'll do my best.
What's the plan?
I'll cut through.
I will prevail.
What's my strategy?
I'll fight to the very end. Don't blame.
I'm awake.
You're here, Mother.
A rising flame was alight as the flow of time carved a new history for Fodlan. Rhea's wild rampage was put to an end, averting what could have been the greatest crisis in the history of Fodlan. After 5.5 years of war, a new age was set to begin. The Empire, Kingdom, and Alliance, all political structures that had once shaped the continent, were gone. A unified nation began to take shape under the watchful eye of the Church of Saros. The Church's new leader became a champion of the people, working tirelessly to help them overcome the horrors of war and to carve out a path towards reconstruction. Just as Saint Saros tended to those who suffered in wars of the past, Fodlan's new ruler embraced their role as mother of all life and arbiter of every soul.
As I soared through the sky, I spoke with my mother. Tell me, is it wrong for me to be happy that I escaped death? Can you still say such things to me, even after witnessing my other form? Thank you. Somehow I feel as though your acceptance alone is my salvation. My sweet companion, I am entrusting the future of Fodlan to you. It is the only logical choice, as everyone wishes for you to be the new leader of this land. I am not qualified to continue leading the people. Though my intention was to keep the peace in Fodlan, I still propagated a false history and deceived my faithful followers. I also took advantage of my position as Archbishop to further my own selfish goal of seeing my mother again. If my foolish actions had anything to do with the war, I wonder. After all I have done, is it truly acceptable for me to go on living my life? You are aware that it is my fault your fate has been so cruel, are you not? You have become so strong. You and I, we were brought together by the flow of time and bound by the hands of fate. I took you on as a professor, and ever since, I believe with all of my heart that this outcome was meant to be. Oh, perhaps it is disrespectful of me to say that. Because it gives all of the credit to time and to fate, and doesn't pay you due honor for all of the choices you made that brought us to this moment. For all that you have done, for all the joy that you have brought me, thank you. Ever since the tragedy at the Red Canyon, I have lived a solitary life. In an effort to fill the hole left by that solitude, I took up the challenge of reviving the Progenitor God. I wished for you to become the Progenitor God. I wished desperately to be held in my mother's arms once more. But that has changed. Now, I wish only for you to be yourself, and to have you by my side. I love you, dearly, and so, I must ask, will you accept this ring? If you feel the same, I would like nothing more than to spend the rest of my life with you. You brought a ring as well? For me? I am overcome with joy.
I never thought I would know a day so blissful as this. That we found each other. Perhaps that means my mother is looking after us. Guiding us. As the new leader of Fodlan, if you wish for this time of peace to be everlasting, well then, I will happily dedicate my life to supporting your reign. No matter what obstacles we should encounter, I believe that our bond... No, rather our love. I believe that our love can overcome all. Together, we can achieve anything. With our love, we will make Fodlan's future as bright as the stars in the sky.
Thank you. Thank you.